Hello!
Hello!
Mr. Waller is just here.
I'm just draining my
She's
potatoes.
Draining, draining her spuds.
Doing racing.
She's draining
today.
Her spuds. I'm going to go with my hood up, I think, today. There we go. Spuds. Spuds you like. Spuds you like.
Who's doing a roast dinner today?
Who's having a roast? Who's doing a roast? Who's roasting? Oh, you know what I mean. Nicola S, good morning. Joanne Clements, Jackie Roswell, Jessica Woodstock, Sarge Mahmood, Karen Ula, Joanne Clements, Julie Evans, Heather Westgarth, Emma Bev 66 Carter, Sharon Smallwood. God, it's really tickling my throat. How are you all? It's the morning before the day before the morning of the school run. Let's not forget, there's very many elements to this that we mustn't forget. Lots of people have been going to school throughout.
Let me just say a bit of hello first before we just...
No, I am. I'm just saying.
How are you all?
Just remember, as we sit on the cusp of going back to school, that many people are already at school, so it's not a big deal.
How are you all? Hello, Louise Plumpton. Happy Sunday, guys. Happy Sunday to you. Hello, all things... What was that? All things... Katie, going back to school tomorrow. Oh, were you the one that was just over on Instagram saying that?
Excuse me. Making banoffee pie, Karen Ula.
Subject Clark. Hello, how are you?
Karen Ula's making banoffee pie.
Well, I made...
Oh, look, Ellen's making your duck with cherries.
Oh, it's so nice. Oh,
seriously.
I made yesterday a gorgeous Biscoff cheesecake.
It's in the No Name Sunday show.
Shall
today.
I go and get it from the fridge to show them?
Oh, that's a
tease. Do you want to see it?
You're going to be a tease. You're going to show the payoff. No, don't show the payoff.
Payoff
is just beautiful.
Payoff
is beautiful. But we will pop
so
it up somewhere
So we're
going to
be
later.
Eating that later. And I'm making roast chicken, roast potatoes, parsnips, carrots, beans, Yorkshire pudding, stuffing.
Yeah.
And lashings of gravy.
Yeah. And as a little treat yesterday, you probably saw an old Sunday show went up just to kind of just cheer us all up, really. Because fuck all.
Oh, food. Yeah. Did you like it? Oh, somebody had their jab yesterday. Where are you? I've
Cheesecake
lost you.
Looks so good.
Whoever it was. Brilliant. Oh, there it is. Debbie. Debbie's had a jab yesterday. My dad had his yesterday, so I'm chuffed about that, because he wasn't well before. Oh, there's your mum. Hi, Diane!
Mum! Nanny Diane in the house, loving you all, Mark.
You should come
you
over
coughing?
For a roast.
Are you okay? Look, Nanny Diane, classic mum. You're coughing, are you okay? Yeah, mum, I'm good, don't worry. I was doing a stupid X Factor voice and it tickled my throat. Xander, watched Coming to America last night, two. Well, Coming to America, spelt with a two, new Eddie Murphy film. We thought you looked a bit jaded in the trailer, but I quite fancy that. All things, Katie, are you watching Harry and Meghan tomorrow?
Ah. Yes. If you've just come over to this channel, by the way, just hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so that you don't miss. And if this is your first time on the channel, just have a look round because we've got loads and loads of different content on here, not just these chats.
Ashley Lewis, good question. Mark, when do us 50-year-olds get our jab? Yeah, man, when
pretty
do we get
soon.
Our jab?
I think
I've got jab envy.
I think there's something like 2 million of us now, aren't there? Of our age.
Am Whose I imagining age? That? Your age or my
age? The 56s to the ones that are being jabbed at the moment. 56 to 60.
Do you feel like you're in an elite crew?
I do actually.
Do you feel a bit smug?
I do feel like a chosen one.
Have you got vaccine smugness?
Haven't had it yet, guys, but...
Oh, yeah, Nadia's father's been vaccinated. He's very funny in the telling of the story, isn't he?
Yes.
We vlogged him via Zoom yesterday.
He's very funny in the No Name Sunday.
Oh, my
God. Who liked the No Name Sunday show yesterday?
Yeah, with Lisa.
Did anybody watch it, not family guest members, and watch it, the one we put up yesterday? And what did you think of the Lisa Loves new section? We love it. My sister had hers yesterday. Who's that? Rachel Keelan. My sister had hers yesterday and she's only 23. She's severely asthmatic. That must be such a relief.
Yeah, you get it if you're asthmatic and you've been required hospital treatment or you know, severe sort of treatment. You get it.
We were watching Your Honour the other day, the new Bryan Cranston Sky drama, which is so
good.
Fantastic. But there's an asthma attack in it and it's so horrible.
Well, I do remember when I had my worst asthma attack as a child,
oh,
I remember
God,
it being just it, like that.
It's horrible.
It's a high-pitched wheeze.
Yeah.
It's quite horrible. Someone asking, is it Reese Roberts? We were just asking about The Servant. Yes, we are enjoying The Servant, but I do feel it's kind of lost its way a little bit in the last couple of episodes. It's got a bit ridiculous. But I am looking forward to the conclusion. It pulled it back at episode 8 we watched last night.
Marky and this truly good. I loved it. And your dad is so funny how he wanted to keep in touch with the man who put a gun to him. Well, this is this No Name Sunday.
Isn't it?
In case you're new here, we've got the main channel where we got everything on. We've also got a members area where we do extra content. And we do the No Name Sunday show. And there's a bit in it every week where my dad tells a story. And it turned, I mean, this week's one is so funny. And then he's got another one for next. Of all these times he's been taken for questioning.
He's had so many interrogations, yes. It's quite frightening. Look, this Linda, week's we love one. Lisa loves.
Oh, it's so good, isn't it? This week's one is Betty and Teddy that were arrested.
Anya Dawn, Rans, Trevor, I watched as a non-member, loved it. Oh, good.
Oh,
really
good.
Pleased.
Good.
I mean, it's almost nearly 2 hours long, today's one. Today's one is an hour 45. It's literally about to print, as they say.
Yeah.
But yes,
thank God Teddy's been vaccinated. I know, Julia, I've been so worried. Mm. It's been so annoying that he hasn't been.
Yeah.
I had my first job on Friday, says Amanda. I must say, he did look a bit rough yesterday on Zoom.
Who?
Dad.
He looked small. Yeah, but he said that something had landed on him. He sort of didn't give it much attention, but your mum looked kind of perturbed by the bruises on his arms. They're a right pair. They get into all sorts of... What about the time your mum threw herself on the floor, lost a tooth, your dad had to clamber back up? Do you remember that time years ago in Portugal, your dad ate his own cheek?
Yes.
He got so drunk... He ate his own cheek.
That was so funny.
We came back from...
We left them going off to the restaurant and they were going to come to the restaurant with us.
They waved goodbye to us from the balcony.
They were on a balcony and they were waving goodbye and they were absolutely getting slaughtered. I mean, we came back, he'd bitten through his cheek.
We were with dear Miranda.
Mama's... Oh my God, they are such a hoot. They are... I've gone on holiday with my mum and dad for years. And only Di comes on holiday with us. People that leave their oldies at home, you're missing out on a treat. Oldies on holiday are the best fun. He is wise. He also can be very, very stupid too, Trish, like most men. What's that? Anything interesting?
Nah.
Gifts? Flowers? Nah. Champagne?
Nah.
Lorel Nichols, morning, just finished watching your Sunday show just now, loved it with Lisa. Oh, I'm so happy. We said let's put one up as a treat.
Yeah, thank God Teddy's been vaccinated, absolutely. Nanny Di's been vaccinated, Teddy's been vaccinated.
A friend of ours had to be in A&E yesterday and we were just talking to her. And we just had a real moment of gratitude, didn't we? Because though we're all, and this is just like for all of us, though we're all fed up with being at home and moaning about, and we've just all had enough. God, listening to her tale of what it was like yesterday in A&E and just how dangerous it felt. People coughing and spluttering, masks under people's chins, aggression, people just absolutely distraught with mental health conditions. And she said the staff were on their knees, exhausted. And it just reminded us, didn't we? Actually, we're lucky to be at home. We really, really are. So for any NHS worker, I know we've got some that follow us here. Thank you, because it is just so tough. Mm. I mean, like she said, she just wanted to get home and just like scrub her skin because she just felt like COVID was everywhere. Mm. And we just don't have that sort of fear on a daily basis for 14 hours a day.
Absolutely.
So thank
Absolutely.
You. Thank you.
No, we didn't get a chance in the end to see our lovely friend's baby.
No.
We're rearranging that for another day.
Because we just had so much, Mark had so much editing to do yesterday.
What was I going to say? Yeah, so what are we talking about? Are you dreading the return to school?
Well, yeah, we thought there's a lot being talked about the excitement.
Mm.
And... For so many people, it's so wonderful.
Exciting.
Like friends of mine who are like are so relieved and their kids are over the moon and it's all fantastic. But I do think that the people that don't have that feeling have been a little bit left behind in the conversation. I don't hear anything on the telly about the child that's probably that actually his heart sunk when Boris made his announcement. The child that's not happy at school, that hasn't got loads of friends, that's being bullied, that is overwhelmed, for the parents that have actually quite enjoyed not being over-schedulized and over-stressed and have actually found a different kind of vibe. We just thought it'd be really interesting if any of you are feeling like that to just hear what you've got to say.
Yeah, does anyone feel like that? I mean, I remember when I was young, when I dreaded When I dreaded school, there was no dread like the dread of school. I mean, I don't think you ever dreaded school, but when I had a dread of school, it was, as a child, it was like nothing else. When I knew that there was a particularly tight pinch point where people were bullying me because of my mum and all this kind of stuff. I mean, you know, back in those days, as we were often said on our Confessions of a Modern Parent, you know, we didn't have the language of feeling these things. All I remember feeling was just so stressed and so upset. And I wouldn't talk to my mum about it, just didn't have that sort of relationship, you know. And it was horrendous. And so I just remember thinking, you know, I just thought, you know, when we hear this clamour of parents very funnily saying, yeah, let's chuck the kids back, for God's sake, we want to get, of course, totally get it. We've talked on our parented podcast about how we all want to sling the towel in on being a parent sometimes. This has been the most awful thing.
I hated school. I was bullied for being fat and gay, and it was purgatory.
There you go. I mean, you know, and it's just, you know, I think of a friend of mine, Edwin, who was constantly bullied for being overweight, and it's just,
there's lots of people coming through, actually.
Yeah, let's have a look. But I just quickly want to say something, though, because on LBC today, they were having a number of parents phoning in. And obviously, the children were too young to phone in. And they were saying, we really, really, as everyone, if you're okay and happy with going to school, that's brilliant. That is brilliant.
And yeah, and we're parking that.
But to park that to one side just for a second, because caught up within it is half the stress for the kids that are stressed, is the stress of not feeling as happy about it as all the other kids. That's part of the stress.
Yeah, and that's why we thought it'd be good to have a chat about it, because so that those, because every feeling is valid. Every experience is valid. If you're not one of the mums or one of the kids that's going, woohoo, let's pop open the Prosecco, get rid of the kids.
We've got some comments here. Rachel Kelleher, my nephew's autistic and does not want to go back. My sister is looking at secondary schools and has found out just how let down he's been by his current school. She's really not happy sending him back. Anna Wright, feels so bad sending my daughter back tomorrow. Her anxiety is sky high.
Oh, Anna, can we take a moment with Anna?
Yeah.
From one mum to another.
Absolutely.
Oh, my God. And we went through that when your child is, like, really highly, highly anxious. It's just, I don't know how old your daughter is. Oh. I was talking to a friend of mine at work the other day, and I was really, really recommend this book on what to do with your child and worries. We used it with ours. I'll put a link underneath here. Was really, really helpful, but it's just that old saying again, you're only as happy as your unhappiest child. It's enormously stressful as a parent, isn't it? It really is.
This is a really important point here. Julie Everts, I remember being very nervous the first day back after a holiday, but can you imagine going back after a lockdown? Sending positive, yeah, there was always that trepidation. Some of it was nervous-sighted, obviously, because you wanted to see your friends and stuff like that.
And for the older kids, they're really worried that they're not going to have anything to say. It's like, I remember Carlitos saying that after the first lockdown. What will we talk about? You know, we've made these friendships. How will we just go back to those friendships? Because it is hard to make friendships at school.
Absolutely.
It's not a breeze for everybody.
No, and Kez C, this is really good. Kez C, I hated school. It was like a strategic war game. Bang on. What
trying
a good description.
To get through the
trying to get through the bullying. It was, all of it is strategic. And I think, you know, Wonder Woman says in answer to Xander's bullying recollection, life gets better after school for a lot of people. And I think it's really important to remember this, that I think
they're always told it's their best days of their life. And I think that's really wrong, because if you're having a shit time and you're told this is the best.
Yeah.
I mean, God, that's going to put a very grey outlook on things.
But you can understand why that is. That is because socially we have to all sign up to it as the way that it works. We all have to sign up to it.
Because there's
you know, you can't, but can you not have more options? I think you can.
Well, no, at the moment there aren't. Because unless you can homeschool.
No, absolutely.
Then you do, which we were able to. Just want to say, just quickly, there is this really massive misconception about homeschooling that rich people homeschool. I've never met a rich homeschooler. It's like people have often, the people that I've met are often struggling, actually, because one of them's had to stop work to be able to do it. But their child has been so unhappy that it's actually, in the end, it's like been worth it. So, yeah.
Moonchild, my children are so much happier being homeschooled and we're staying that way, as they both say they prefer it, and I love them being at home and are doing so well.
Oh! Yeah. Moonchild, have you read our book, Honey, I Homeschooled the Kids? It might be helpful to you, because God, we really fucked up so much at the beginning, and it might be helpful if you're just starting out with it.
Yeah, yeah. Natalie Reed, the kids are looking forward to it, but my anxiety is through the roof. Playground for adults is frightening. Laura M, as a teacher, I see firsthand how difficult coming back to school can be for some children. Our main focus tomorrow is well-being and mental health, not data and assessment. Yeah, but Laura M, that's interesting that you say our main focus tomorrow is well-being and mental health. You're absolutely, and that's really nice to know and hear. Let's just hope that in the charge to make up for lost
with
time,
the adrenaline,
and with the adrenaline-fueled rush of Gavin Williamson, and my slight concern with Gavin Williamson is that he's had such a spectacularly terrible pandemic that he's going to overzealously push. I mean, we're looking at 5-term years, we're looking at no summer holidays. You know, I mean, I think one of the quick and easiest ways, and in fact, they had someone from, I think, Ofsted on the radio this morning saying that she kind of agrees that exams are only, you know, a lot of schools get bogged down in teaching kids how to pass exams rather than teaching kids stuff that's learned, you know, it's the age-old question mark. And she said that we do need to find the balance that's right between firing up our kids in their hearts rather than just firing them up to kind of
like
pass
in
an
a
exam.
State of panic.
And I just think that somehow coursework would take a lot of pressure off the timeline, surely, of school.
Yeah.
I mean, I know it necessitates more work for the teachers, but could we not find a system of subcontracting out a lot of the marking of the coursework? You know, I mean, I know Fleur does a lot of that sort of stuff. You know, there are lots of graduates and kids and grown-ups like myself, you know, with lots of people who could mark and work for the exam boards. And just, you know, I just think there are other ways. And I think sometimes we get locked into thinking there's just one way. And here's the other thing. We were talking about this the other day.
Exactly, Tina Fey. That's what I was saying.
You weren't here when we were talking about it. I was talking about the fact that when I was young, lots and lots of kids left school at 14 or 16 and no one batted an eyelid. Lots of kids left school. Lots of kids went straight into the workplace.
Not allowed to.
Well, no, you're not allowed to. But I think that's the difference. Just because you're not allowed to doesn't necessarily mean this is the right thing for your kids. Yeah. Because not all kids does it suit. And I think that's just something to bear in mind. Because, you know, tomorrow it's going to be, all it's going to be all over the press is the joy, the joy, the joy. And for many, it is the joy. But I really feel for those people who...
It's
going to mark a return to bullying. It's going to mark a return to comparison. It's going to mark a return to not being able to keep up with everyone.
I just want to read this. Patrick, that is absolutely horrific what is happening to you. And I can't believe the teachers ignore it. Please, I don't know how old you are, but Childline is there for any age. Mm. And I really, really, really would urge you to call them. Another really good... organization to get in touch with is the Princess Diana Anti-Bullying Campaign. They're fantastic. Please reach out to somebody. That really is too much to bear, what you're going through.
Absolutely.
So reach out to someone, all the Samaritans. Obviously, I don't know what your life is like at home, but that's a lot.
Yeah,
you must
Patrick,
be feeling absolutely horrible about going in tomorrow. So our heart goes out to you.
And Colette Norman says, as a highly anxious child, my heart totally goes out to those children like me. I know my anxiety would have been going into overdrive.
Exactly.
Sarah Clemmy, backing up what I just said, my godson left school at 15 and is enjoying a joinery apprenticeship. Yeah, I mean, my point is just simply that we didn't bat an eyelid. And also, if I had, you know, when I...
Yeah,
when
we did that change.
Yeah, yeah, no, but when The Apprentice came, do you remember when The Apprentice first arrived and it was a fanfare and everyone was Alan Sugar devotees?
Yeah.
And the biggest selling point about Alan Sugar, I don't know if you remember this, and it always is with entrepreneurs, the biggest selling point usually of most entrepreneurs in this country is they came out of school... They left school early. They taught themselves in the world. This is always the narrative. You always hear it about so many of our entrepreneurs. They left school early. It wasn't for them. They went it alone. And we champion that as kind of like the proof of the underdog. And yet suddenly we lose our nerve when it comes to...
Yeah.
The individual needs of all of our children. We think, God, that's all right for one, but it's not all right for all.
Yeah.
You know, it's kind of, there's just been a gear change. And I think partly it's because of economically, we don't have enough jobs and we don't have enough to occupy all of the needs of all of these kids coming through a system. So best thing to do, it's a bit like, do you remember in the 80s, they used to have all these youth training schemes and there'd always be these outcries about you're manipulating the unemployment figures by putting them all on the unemployment courses. I think it's the same thing. It's about delaying the inevitable arrival of all these people into the workplace.
Jessica Woodstock, I'm really sorry to read that. Jessica says she was bullied all the way through school and then bullied by her employer.
Oh, God.
That is... awful.
Jessica.
And it's interesting that I noticed that you put a laughter emoji there, because obviously that's your way of dealing it, but that's not okay.
No.
That's not okay. You know what could be... You know what? I don't know if you've had any CBT or anything, Jessica, but maybe it are, because I know you've had other stuff going on in your life as well. I wonder if you could ask for a referral from your doctor to speak to somebody, because that could be a pattern that you could break. You don't have to accept that. You don't have to make that the story of your life. This, your story of your life can change.
Yeah.
You know? So, yeah, reach
Jessica,
out.
Sending big love, Jessica.
Yeah.
Elsa Pop, I was bullied my whole school life. Home was my safe place. Really feel for the bullied kids
so
tomorrow.
I
used to hate Sundays, the thought of school the next day.
So do I. I really do feel for them. And I feel for the parents. Because, you know, one of ours was bullied and it's just... the most horrible, horrible feeling when you have to send them back knowing that they're going to have a shit day. It's just, and that the school's not going to do anything. It's just so hard.
Couple of birthdays. Someone somewhere, it's your 45th. And Chloe, it's your 21st. I've made a note with a pen that's diminishing in its ink content. Mask Kid, in Australia, we do coursework in high school. Not everyone does the exams. What? So sensible.
Why can we not rethink?
I personally want to start a campaign. I mean, I made contact with Ken Robinson's estate to talk about our book with them, and they've come back to me, and I'm sending them a copy. We're hopefully meeting for a coffee once we come out of lockdown to have a talk about things. I want to campaign for coursework assessment for all students.
Yeah.
Because you're not going to lose out for not doing a test. I know lots of people say it's
understand.
A good opportunity to test you and work towards
it. But it's like we were saying this on This Women the other day. It becomes just a memory game.
Of course it
because
does.
Because where in any job do you have to sit and remember every single thing? It's
totally artificial.
And there are so many different kinds of brains. It's like, I've got quite a good brain, but I don't have a brilliant memory, so I'm never going to be any good in an exam situation. Does that make me somehow a failure?
Yeah,
because that's what it feels like if you're at school and you don't pass exams.
Mm.
Sarah Robinson, I was bullied all throughout school, and now at 38 years old, I have social anxiety. That is what we always say. When people say, if you take a bullied child out of school, then what are you showing them? You're showing them that, you know, they're going to be weak. They're never going to learn how to deal with people. I just don't agree with that. Imagine if you're at work and somebody's bullying you and you're in a job you hate and somebody keeps saying to you, well, you've got to stay there because you've got to show your steel metal. And we do that to children. We do that to children. Mm. You've got to prove yourself by staying in the most horrific situation.
Yeah.
Because that will make you strong. No. Oh, it gets me.
Shelley Moss. We were the first. I'm really pleased you've mentioned this, Shelley. The year after me was the first year of GC. I was the last year of O-levels. And I remember, as I obviously went up to A-levels, friends and kids in the classes beneath me, and we had a huge coursework component to our O-levels even. I mean, I don't know whether it was the school we were at, you know. But she says, we were the first year to do GCSEs when they first came in. This was about 86 or 87.
That was 100% course.
100%. English was 100%. Because I remember when I did my English O-level, it was something like 50% coursework, 50% exam. And then when the GCSEs came through the following year, it was 100% coursework.
Why did they change it then?
Which way? What are you talking about?
Well, if it's 100% coursework and now
they're back
to exams.
Precisely, that's what she's saying.
But why have they changed?
Why did it come back? Even maths was
100%. I never knew that.
Maths was 100% exam, and I can kind of understand that. It's about sums and all that.
Yeah.
That makes sense. But all the others were 50-50. Also, science projects, art projects, history projects, they were all 50-50.
What is the percentage now?
I don't know. No. And I think it's different for different exam boards, but I think it's something like 20%. I just don't.
Yeah.
I don't,
Sarah Clement, exactly. It's the best idea in your job. You're more likely to have to write or communicate.
Of course you are.
Not under exam pressure.
Of course you
communication.
Are.
Like,
and
why
it's
not
also
make every part of the
isn't
exam
it's
a bit of an oral thing as well? Where you get, because what about people that are much better
talking
than writing?
But also, it's about comprehending what you've learned. Surely, it's about taking it in and understanding it. And
yeah,
there are very few situations in a work. And also, you know, you can do all of the qualifications that you need to do academically at school for numeracy, literacy, what have you. My big debate is that there should be as much emphasis on creativity. James Flanagan, I saw your comment go up. You know, you should have all of that. But then, of course, when you go into jobs, you're not going to, you know, you have particular sort of training specific to your job, don't you? Mm. Even if you work in a bar, You have bar training. Do you remember? You have those. I remember. Oh, you come in on Sunday. You can have a day training on the bar. I remember that the first pub I worked. Every job has its tailored, specific training. So it's not like you're going to even enter a job totally at sea if you haven't got the right bloody GCSE. Mm. I literally don't understand why coursework couldn't be spread across all the subjects. I would argue that your children would end up better educated.
Yeah,
because they would have taken it in and out.
Well, when you hear about Maddie's friends going, we don't bother during the year. We're really good at exams. We scram at the end and we pass the exams really well.
That's a different kind of...
Surely that's a bit messed up.
Yeah.
But anyway, for those of us that don't have children going to school or any of that.
Well, all the debate that we're talking about in the No Name Sunday show where we do the headlines is, hang on, let's just finally on the schools thing. The news story this morning is we're going to have longer school days, shorter summer holidays and 5 term years all under consideration.
Madness.
Can I just say,
madness.
One thing that amount that
Send
comes out of
panic.
All of those is stress.
Stress.
It's stress.
I think it's madness.
Yeah. Oh, look, Nads, and there's a whole news story here about vaccine offers for all those aged 56 or over.
I've got my
arbitrary
next
age.
Thursday next.
Is it 56?
Over 55, because we're more at risk than you are under 55. It's just year by year, isn't it?
Mm. Weird. Seems like such. Why not 55 then?
Darling, I don't know the answer to these things.
Please tell me. So there we go. Oh, God. So it's Meghan Markle. It's Meghan Markle and it's Harry. That is going to be all we're going to hear wall to wall for the next 24 hours.
Yeah.
And you know what? If you can't beat them, dive into the pool and just swim amongst them.
So
which
do
is what we're
make
gonna do.
Sure that you join us straight afterwards here because we are going to chat all the way through it
but can
in
I just,
detail.
Can I just ask, though, does anyone know, not that I'm wanting to do ITV a disservice, but can you watch it when it goes out anywhere? I mean, it's going out tonight in America. Can you watch it as it goes out tonight?
Oh, it airs 1 a.m. UK time, MeTube. MeTube knows everything.
Where MeTube? Where? 1 a.m. Oh, my God. I mean, that's the time to do it. Which channel is it on? It's airing at 1 a.m. It will be on YouTube, as Xander says.
Or somebody there giving us a reason for the ages. Zoe, it's 5 years at a time. That's why.
Oh, 5 years at a time. Thanks, Zoe Shah. Laura Byrne, can my bestie Emma, happy birthday.
From Laura and Loretta.
My pen is running out.
Okay. Laura
from
and Loretta.
Laura.
Well, let's do it now. Happy birthday, Emma. Happy birthday, Emma. Happy birthday, dear Emma, from your friends, Laura and Loretta. Happy birthday to you.
Nazanin, due to be released today.
Is it happening?
Nazanin Zaghari.
No, Jube, but we don't know. We don't know if they're going
to
let...
Set to be released today. Oh, fingers crossed.
Let's have a look, see if they've said anything. Oh, we've had her husband on Loose Women for a couple of times and a nicer, sweeter, more broken-hearted man you will not meet. Oh, my God, it's so unfair what's happened to her. Is there any news? It's the sort of thing they could do is just snatch it away from her again. And you know her daughter has had a calendar counting down.
Oh, no.
And because when she was in Iran, her mum had done a calendar herself.
Right.
So she wanted one here. I think her dad was a bit reluctant because he was a bit... But anyway, they've been doing it. And he said she's gone quieter as she's picked up the vibrations of the adults around her.
Oh, no. Oh, God.
I know.
Oh, God.
I know. As they become more cautious because they just don't know.
Oh, God, don't. Oh. Two other birthdays. Chloe, 21st.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to
you, Chloe.
Happy birthday, dear Chloe.
21.
Happy birthday to you.
21, that's a biggie. And then someone somewhere, it's your 45th. Happy birthday
to
you.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday,
someone somewhere.
Where are you, someone somewhere?
Happy birthday to you.
Well, there we go, guys.
Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Hit the subscribe. And hit the notification bell.
No, and the No Name Sunday Show will be landing later. Have fun and have a lovely Sunday.
Don't forget to put in your timer to join us after the Meghan and Harry.
Oh, my God.
Mm-mm.
Bye.